sir.
Good morning.
Who's got the
controls for the sound? Owen.
I think I'm muted on my microphone. Are we good now? Oh, stereo. Excellent.
I think so. We're good. Okay. All right. Good morning. Good morning. I had a whole spiel in my head, and it's gone now that we had some fun. So if you have a bulletin, there's some information in there. Okay. Good to know, right? There's information. Part of that information is our weekly prayer letter called Moving Mountains. Moving Mountains. That was kind of clever, wasn't it? I didn't come up with it, just so you know. But there's items on both pages, so if you could put this up somewhere, your vanity mirror, the dashboard of your car, wherever it is that you are going to see it on a daily basis to remember to pray for these things. And then halfway through the week, flip it. And then you can pray for those items on the back page too. But as you noticed when I flipped it, there's this handy dandy bottom section where I'm going to put my finger there. And then when I flip it around, you can actually tear off this bottom portion. Boom. And you can let us know if you have any prayer items or concerns this morning. And you can drop them in the offering plates at the back when you leave, or in the middle of the service, or whenever you get bored with my sermon. Just get up, drop it in there. You know, if you draw a picture of a horse and you want to share it with me, I'll put it on there. Or as the church curmudgeon likes to say, you know, the pastor's praying about whether we move to pews versus chairs, because he has to, because I wrote it on the prayer list, you know. Those things work too. But those are great ways for us to connect with your needs and your concerns and your heart for God. So use that. Or you can always, there is contact information on there for how you can get added to this prayer list and any emergent needs as well. Next week, notice probably the most pertinent information for next week is if you come to church at the time you came to church today, next week. So if you come to church like you did today, only next week, you're going to be late. We're going to be done with the music, the good portion of the service, and you're just going to be stuck with me all service long, because we start our worship service at 9:30. So next week, starting our summer schedule, there's no Sunday school. There still is fellowship time afterwards, so the coffee will be ready, the coffee will be hot, but 9:30 Sunday morning worship next week. Got it? Got it.
Got it.
I hope you don't have plans for after this immediate service, because there is really good coffee downstairs. Really good coffee. Not last week's coffee. I joked that it was bad coffee last week. Turns out, it's like one of those things where I thought I was wrong one time, and it turns out I was right. Yeah, it was really terrible coffee. It was especially terrible. Anybody have the coffee last week? Yeah, yeah, right? It was bad.
It like water? Like you could see through it.
Yeah. I watched someone pour a cup, and I'm like, what is this? I made that coffee, and I don't know what happened.
It's the coffee pot.
It's the coffee pot? Oh. It wasn't my fault?
It was the pot.
There you go. Bad coffee, good fellowship. Every single time. Well, today maybe we'll have both. Good and bad coffee. So next week, 9:30. This week, hang out. Texas caviar, sweets, cupcakes, whatever you want to enjoy downstairs. So enjoy, stick around, have a good Sunday morning. But you guys didn't come here for the coffee. I can guarantee you that. You came here to worship Jesus Christ together, right? So let's do that. Let's worship Jesus Christ, the Savior of our souls, the Creator of our universe, the Sustainer of our lives. Let's begin with Psalm 97, and then we'll pray. The Lord reigns. Let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all the peoples see his glory. All who worship images are put to shame. Those who boast in idols worship him, all you gods. Zion hears and rejoices, and the village of Judah are glad because of your judgments, O Lord. For you, O Lord, are the most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. Let those who love the Lord hate evil, for he guards the lives of his faithful ones and delivers them from the hands of the wicked. Light is shed upon the righteous and joy on the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord, you who are righteous, and praise his holy name. Let's pray. O God, the King of glory, you have exalted your only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph to your kingdom in heaven. Do not leave us comfortless, but send us your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and exalt us to that place where our Savior Christ has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen. Let's pray. Let's
want to pray again?
Sing.
We'll sing. Can pray again if you want.
Let's sing.
Good morning. I've only had about 3 months to prepare and did not. But we're going to have a lovely time this morning singing. So why don't we stand and let's worship together as a society of pardoned rebels. Because we did something to be worthy, but because he claims we are worthy, amen? Because Lord knows the guy that wrote the song Easy on Sunday morning is a liar. Those of you getting kids ready this morning, you know what I'm talking about. And screaming. But we gather not because we've perfected ourselves and made ourselves ready for this moment. We gather because we want to worship together as a society of pardoned rebels. Amen? Let's do it. Society of pardoned rebels, all with different life experiences, singing, you give and take away, but yet blessed be your name. Isn't that a lovely thing? We're bound by a power greater than we can ever know, and a love greater than we can ever know. Still dealing with a little COVID, so I gotta take a drink. We have a special individual in our midst, just one. And her name is Lily, and she's graduating from high school today. And yay! You've accomplished what we asked you to do. But you did it well. And we're going to sing a song that she has requested as her favorite tune to sing together as a society of pardoned rebels. your prayers, our heart. Is given to us, is provided. It doesn't just happen. There's a divine creator that loves us, created human beings to fulfill his purpose. Then we went and screwed it up, yet he still provides breath. Our lungs. I act like I haven't figured out. I don't know what the heck's going on. I just know I love Jesus and he loves me. Amen. A little bit of COVID.
second or the third verse there. Oh, the my sin, oh, the bliss of this glorious thought. My sin, not just part of it, but the whole thing has been nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. It's good to have family here, friends here, a day of celebration for many of us on this Memorial Day weekend. Let us take some time in prayer. Father, thank you for the words of your Son who said, truly I tell you, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. Father, thanks for this time where we can gather and pray. The power of prayer is something beyond our imagination as well. As we sang, your love is greater than anyone can comprehend. Father, in a week where we saw another tragedy in Texas, Father, we realize we live in a sinful world. You give, you take away, and yet we say, glory be to your name. Father, may the peace that passes all understanding be on all those who were affected and who will not forget that day for the rest of their lives. Lord God, forgive us as a nation for falling away from you. Lord, our cry is that we would draw close to you and you will draw near to us. Father, we praise you for Declan's short stay in the hospital last week. We lift up Jim, we lift up Deb as they're experiencing surgeries coming up. And Lord God, you are the great physician. We pray for successful surgeries, for testimonies that give you praise. Lord God, we lift up Tori and Nick. June is nearly here. They are expecting a baby in June. We pray for a healthy baby, a safe delivery, and just the excitement that they and we as a church family can share. The miracle of another baby. Father, we pray for the graduating seniors. We pray for Lily, for Demetrius, for Caden from this church, for the rest of the class here at Cavalier, a great milestone. Lord, that we pray that you would lead and protect them as they pursue your plan and purpose for their lives. They have many choices ahead of them. May they be wise. Lord God, we are excited for Cooperstown Bible Camp to get started, for the staff there, for the ministry that happens, for the kids, the adults that have life-changing moments there. We pray for your protection on that camp as they start up soon. Father, we pray for our school again. They are now done with school for the summer. Thank you for the teachers, for all who commit to teaching our young people. Father, we pray for the continued war, even though it seems to have taken the back burner now in Ukraine and Russia. There are horrible things happening there yet. Lord God, keep that in our minds, that we can uplift that situation in our prayers. Bring peace to a chaotic situation, a situation that we don't understand. But you are on the throne, Lord. Glory be to your name. Father, we pray that our hearts would be open, our ears receptive to your inerrant and wonderful word that Pastor Bill is about to bring us. Lord God, prepare his heart, his lips to bring us your word. In your powerful and holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Bob. Thanks, Kyle. Kids, if you're ready for children's church, you can head on downstairs. done restricting you kids. Just get out. Go. You're Emily's problem now. In Galatians chapter 3, Paul writes, "You are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. For all of you who were baptized into Christ,
Amen, amen. Would you please stand as we close? To my friends and family and those that know me, and then now especially to those that don't, I tend to be a little liberal with my speech. I do not have COVID, so do not be afraid. I have a cold. So even though I joke about it, just to be clear.
Did like, you have a discussion with your wife in the back?
Yeah, she's like, smoking on my wife over there. You gotta stop joking about COVID. So I have two positive tests to prove to you. Just kidding. I don't, probably. But I do want to pose an interesting question. I have been a Christ follower, I would suggest, my entire life, and I've never been baptized. And I am currently, at this moment, struggling with whether or not to be baptized. Isn't that a weird one? Or baptized? Baptized again? Weird. I don't know. Love your feedback. But let's... Thank you.